I'm Ross.
And Adam.
We're the 1975. We were never really troublemaking kids. We were never really the kind of go out, I don't know, get drunk on the park kind of kids. We were more stay in, play video games.
We went and did music and played in his garage for like years instead of going out looking for trouble and stuff.
Being from somewhere where there's not really anything to battle against, you know, everyone's parents are all right, everyone lives in a kind of all right house. I think if you grow up anywhere like that, you always kind of take it with a pinch of salt to a certain extent, and there's always a kind of counterculture that's slightly subverting it. The idea of yearning for something bigger within our music doesn't come from a place of kind of economic issues or class issues. It comes from a very kind of idealistic teenage perspective. When we first started out as the 1975, the reason everything was in black and white is A, because it was the juxtaposition that I always talk about of poppy, uplifting music and an aesthetic that is more dour or provokes you to be more introspective or think about it. Life-affirming music and visuals that make you think about life. Because we didn't really know who we were, we didn't really know what we were doing. We'd been told by every major label in the world that we didn't know what we were doing. And I think the black and white thing, we really found solace in the fact that we weren't 100% exposed.
Never a conscious decision to make 80s sounding music. It's not like, yeah, let's go and sound 80s. We found comfort in writing pop music that was surrounded by kind of these ethereal ambient sounds.
We never have an agenda when we're writing music. That's because we did it by ourselves without anyone watching. You know, that's when you're at your most honest, isn't it? When no one knows who your band is.
We had our first play on radio. We all sort of sat around the radio at Matty's house and like we're all like over the moon with that. Thankfully for us, this whole year has just been a constant sort of tick list of goals that we wanted to achieve, and our shows are still getting bigger and selling out and like all around the world. I mean, the crowds are getting bigger and the reactions are getting stronger and more fanatic, and that keeps you happy.